Walapa, how you doing folks? Man, nilikuwa penda yo salamu by the way. Old school like crazy. Walapa. How you doing? Welcome back, Football Digest, where we eat, sleep, football, repeat. Kama kawa, my name is Nyash, Yule Boy. And like I always do, and like I always love to do, I always love to bring you up to speed with what is happening in the world of sports, and more so football. Because, you know, football is everything. You know, like I said, we eat, sleep, football, repeat. So yeah, some of the news that I've been making headlines, no league has started yet. Obviously, so the only news that are making headlines here, it's more of transfer market and, you know, a few other tidbits here and there. And I want to give you that AOBs before I do the transfer market. So the AOBs are one, Jacques Tuyisenge. Yeah, that name is quite confusing. Tuyisenge has won the June Player of the Month in Kenya, courtesy of SportPesa, and he has been awarded 100,000 Kenya shillings alongside a trophy and alongside the big one, 49-inch LG Smart TV. My God. I would do anything to get such a screen, man. Oof. Amazing. So you gotta give it up to him. He scored 5 goals in that month. And of course, he helped Gor Mahia win all the games in that month. And that is quite something. It's honestly quite something. However, my question is, why is he being given this award at the end of July? Isn't this supposed to be done like at the starting of July? Then at the starting of August, to give whoever won the Player of the Month in July? Kind of doesn't make sense here, does it? It's a little too late, but then again, it's what it is. He has won the award. Something else that has made headlines is Ali Kiba has signed for Ilaitwa Coastal Union FC. Officially and professionally, he has signed a one-year contract with Coastal Union FC in Tanzania to be playing football. Man, that is quite something, manze. That is what people like me envy. Like, I'm jealous and dream of, you know? Like, kusainua professional kuwa na cheza ball, mse. Eish. Inaweza kuwa dope sana. So that has happened. Something that has made headlines is, of course, Cristiano Ronaldo's £16.9 million fine for tax evasion in Spain and a 2 years jail sentence. But then again, if you're wondering, like, he's gonna go to jail now, he ain't. I mean, 2 years is considered too small a time for you to actually go in jail, literally, in Spain and be incarcerated. So not gonna happen, and he's gonna just pay out the fine. But then again, for a guy like Cristiano, who for any sponsored post that he posts on Instagram, he earns more than $500,000. Clearing out such a fine, it ain't gonna be a huge deal for him, is it? It's gonna be something very easy for him. So yes, he has been signed £16.9 million for tax evasion in Spain. So no other news that has made headlines that is not related to transfer. So let's just go to transfers. And I want to start with the Malcolm deal. You know Malcolm signed for Barcelona instead of AS Roma, like he was seriously touted. And AS Roma was so infuriated. And now they're saying, like, the only way they can feel compensated, because I was reading something a few days ago. They were saying, like, they're going to sue Bordeaux. They're going to sue Barcelona, you know. So we want to see how this one is going to turn out. Wanasema, do you feel sufficiently compensated at Barcelona wapatie Messi? Biggest joke of the day I've seen today. So, yes, it's going to be interesting to see how that one turns out. Of course, they're not gonna get Messi. I mean, even in their dream, they ain't gonna get Messi. Malcolm going to Barcelona started leaving these questions and answered questions to do with Dembele. You know, like, is he gonna leave eventually? Is he gonna stay and fight for his place alongside Malcolm? And why would you sign Malcolm when you have Dembele unless you're looking to loan him out? You know, so it's gonna be something that is worth keeping an eye on to see if Dembele is actually going to leave. He has severally been linked to the move to Arsenal, but I don't know if Arsenal can actually buy. Because, man, for a guy who was bought £162 million, Uwe Kuhuza maybe $70 million, maybe £70 million. I don't see Arsenal forking out such an amount of money for him. I don't. But maybe they can start with getting him on loan, because we need a winger like yesterday. Yesterday, because of these young guys, we need them badly. Which brings me to my next point. Alphonso Davies. Who knew this guy? Because I didn't until I had him being linked with Bayern Munich. And he has officially moved to Bayern Munich. And he's going to be joining them once the MLS season ends in January. He has been bought for $13 million. Which is actually an MLS record fee. Because no player has ever been bought for such an amount from the MLS. You know, too. MLS ndiko wazee wenda kuretire. Kuonaona Beverly Hills, you know, California, New York and shit. But yes, this one is going to be moved from MLS to Bundesliga next season. And he has been bought for $13 million. A record, like I said, the previous record was held by one Jose Altido when he moved to Villarreal in 2008 from New York Red Bulls, and they paid $11 million. Yes, Alphonso Davies, I think, is 17 years old. Yes, I think he's 17 or 18 years old, and Ndio naona it's like a trend now in clubs. These big clubs, they're only signing these young promising guys who most of the times are attacking players. Alphonso Davies, Bayern Munich. Barcelona have bought Malcolm. They also have Dembele. Malcolm is 21 years old. Dembele, I think, is 24. Real Madrid, they signed Vinicius Jr. One heck of a talent, by the way. He's so talented. You should check out his clips on YouTube. My God. He is dope. He's dope. And I've also seen some clips of him in training. Hey, we're saying Noma. No doubt, ni mnoma. If you look at Manchester City, they have Leroy Sané. If you look at Manchester United, they have Rashford. If you look at, which other team is this? Liverpool. Liverpool, of course. They have, who do they have? Okay, theirs are not attacking talents. They are more like fullbacks. Unajua fullbacks wao? Robertson and Alexander Arnold. So it's like a thing in clubs, you know. Even Atletico Madrid, who just signed Gelson Martins, you know, from Sporting Lisbon. He's still young, and they have Thomas Lemar also, who is still young. I think he's under 25. So these young and promising guys that all these big clubs are buying and more of attacking talents, I've not seen any of such talent at Arsenal. Like, what the hell is going on? You know, like, Arsenal tuna yule mtu yunaweza sema, eh, mtu yalingara last season, so atakuwa analeta shida hii season. Atuna. No one. And we all know Arsenal needs a winger right now, and I'm looking at all the options that we have, and we can't get any. We can't get any. We only have Kingsley Coman. And one of my friends, he hates those links between Arsenal and Coman. Mbaya. Mbaya sana. So, I'm looking at all the options that we have left, and I can't seem to find any. The only one that comes to mind is Leon Bailey. And Leon Bailey is looking more likely to go to Chelsea than to come to Arsenal. Because I've seen some previous posts of him in a Chelsea jersey. And I'm thinking, yeah, maybe he might just go to Chelsea. And then we'll be left with Coman only. I'm waiting to see what exactly Arsenal is going to do. Because we all know Arsenal needs a winger. Needs a winger. And what hurts me by the most, I've talked about my brother who hates being linked with, who hates it when Arsenal is linked with Coman, because Arsenal missed out on Malcolm. What hurts me more is Arsenal missing out on Gelson Martins. And Gelson Martins signed for Atletico Madrid on a free transfer. Yani, hawajalipa shit. Of course, I've read an article today and they were saying Atletico Madrid actually did compensate Sporting Lisbon, I think, with 32 million euros. I don't know how true that is. And now Sporting Lisbon are saying before Gelson Martins terminated his contract, the release clause of 100 million euros had already been triggered. And so they want Atletico Madrid to actually pay them 100 million euros. And they're going to take that case to FIFA. And you're waiting to see how that one's going to turn out. I don't think they will win. But then again, you never know. They might actually just win it and get paid that amount of money. But Arsenal is missing out on talents. Especially the wings, zenye tunajua tunahitaji sana, and it hurts. It absolutely hurts. So those are some of the things that have been happening. Another transfer that has happened that is quite mind-blowing is Richarlison signing for Everton for £50 million. That for me is a heck of an exaggeration. I don't think he's worth £50 million. He scored, I think, 6-7 goals last season. 5 goals when Marco Silva was coaching Watford. After that, he just portaleaed. I don't know where he went. But he's now signed for Everton and he's going to be reuniting with his manager. João Moutinho has signed for Wolves for £5 million from Monaco. And I think that's one heck of an acquisition for Wolves. I mean, these teams that have been promoted, two of them are seriously doing their best to get new players to come on board and quality players. Like Wolves, they have Rui Patricio, who they signed from Sporting Lisbon. They have Neves, another Portuguese. And they have João Moutinho, another Portuguese. And they also signed Johnny Otto. Johnny Otto has signed for Atletico Madrid, but he has been loaned out for a season long loan to Wolves. And I've seen another link between Pepe and Wolves. I'm like, Wolves, unataka kuwa Portuguese side ama ni nini? Or atakuwa na wase wanne Portuguese? Hey, it's gonna be very interesting to see how that one turns out. Another team that has been promoted is Fulham. They have already signed Jean-Michel Seri, a guy that was heavily linked with Arsenal, but didn't materialize. They have also signed Andre Schala. From Borussia Dortmund, who was, of course, playing for Chelsea a couple of seasons ago. So they are trying their best to, you know, sign quality players and, you know, so that they can be able to assert themselves next season when the 2018-19 season kicks off. And this is just making it even more interesting. Even more interesting. But one thing that is totally interesting, by the way, is the signing of one Robert Green by Chelsea. He's 38 years old. He has been signed as a backup to Willy Caballero and Thibaut Courtois. So who I think for me, he'll definitely be going to Madrid, just like Eden Hazard. And I'll be shocked by that if Chelsea will be able to keep hold of Thibaut Courtois, Eden Hazard, and Willian. If they're able to keep those three players, then that will be something huge for Chelsea. It's going to be very interesting. I think two of those three players are going to leave Chelsea. Yes. So those are some of the transfers that I was talking about. So many others have happened that are not maybe worth the salt. But if you want to know more about it, just go to our Facebook group and check out, because that's where I do all the posts of any transfers that happened. Big transfers that happened, I post them on my Facebook group. And you can also check me on Instagram. I also do it on my stories over there at Nyash, NYAWSH. All right. That's all I have for you guys. Maybe one more thing I should add is Mbappe has been given the number 7 jersey by PSG. We all know his idol dons the number 7 jersey. So maybe he just want to emulate him even in the jersey that he's wearing. And I'm sure Zel Mbappe is going to be killing it this season. He's going to kill it so badly. And when he moves to Madrid next season or 2 seasons from now, he's going to be a world record fee. World record fee. And I don't think anyone will come close to that. I'm so sure about that. And of course, I've also seen PSG's new away kit, and they look every bit like Madrid's with the exception of the stripes. And you're like, shit, PSG are doing everything they can to make sure Mbappe and Neymar feels like they are at Madrid. You know, because it's okay, maze zinagatu za Madrid, maze zinagatu za Madrid, zinagatu za Madrid. So those are the stories that I think are worth sharing and are worth the salt and are worth talking about in my broadcast. Thank you so much for keeping it here. Don't forget to subscribe and like, subscribe on our YouTube channel, Football Digest KE. Check out our Facebook group, Football Digest, and we can keep this conversation going and sharing more insights on football stories and football matters. All right? Have a fantastic weekend. Make it count. God bless.